What up, you nerds? Fallout here, and today we've got a little bit of an update video that I can't wait to share with you. Rewind the clock real quick. Last weekend, I put out a video talking about the changes to Whisper of Fissures and Shatterdive from Bungie's recent 3.0.2 patch, and how I wasn't really sure if it actually went into effect or not. My final thoughts on the matter were that A, either the Whisper of Fissures nerf didn't go through at all, or B, it did go through, and it's just not as strong as we thought. Turns out, it's the latter of those two. Whisper of Fissures did get nerfed, but it's all still really strong. More on those numbers in a minute. On top of that, while re-recording a few clips, we did discover a bug for sure with everybody's favorite totally non-broken class, the Behemoth. Okay, first things first, let's give a brief update on the actual numbers behind both Shatterdive and Whisper of Fissures. Big shout out to Kujay, by the way, who initially covered this topic in his in-depth video on Stasis, and whom I spoke to regarding a lot of the upcoming numbers. Alright, here we go. Glacier Nade and Shatterdive together without even touching Whisper of Fissures is incredibly strong on its own. The damage varies on how close you are to the Glacier Nade getting shattered. Obviously, the max damage you can get per crystal is 84, which will happen if you're right up there giving it a hug. And the least damage you can do per crystal is 46, which happens at a max range of 6 meters away. Meaning, if you're any further away than 6 meters, which is about this range right here, you're not going to take any damage from Shatterdive. It is 6 meters or closer. Again, this is all base Shatterdive info without touching Whisper of Fissures. At max damage per crystal, again, which is 84, and 5 crystals, you're getting 420 blaze it damage off of base Shatterdive. At 6 meters away, which is the furthest point away we can do damage with base Shatterdive, we're looking at 230 damage total. Now, you're less likely to do 230 damage total each time if your enemy is about 6 meters away, though, because even though they are 6 meters away from the crystal in the dead center, they're probably closer to 6.5 meters away from the crystals on the ends of the Glacier Nade wall. Does that make sense? Just because you're 6 meters away from one crystal does not mean you're 6 meters away from every crystal. And because that is true, in practice, it's far more likely that you're gonna get one-hit kills almost every time from 5 meters away with basic Glacier Grenade and Shatterdive. Now, let's talk about Whisper of Fissures, which is the icing on top of the Shatterdive cake. I usually find it very hard to measure Shatterdive and Glacier Nade damage due to the absurd number cluttering going on your HUD. If you just measure things one crystal at a time, though, it becomes much more manageable. So here we go, up close, i.e. if you're literally hugging the Glacier Nade and it gets broken, you're gonna take two damage numbers. 84 is the number we've already covered, that is the max damage from any one Glacier Nade on its own, and then you have 30, that second damage number is the damage coming solely from Whisper of Fissures on its own. If we go back to the 3.0.2 patch notes, boom, that is the exact number we should be seeing from Whisper of Fissures. All right, we have our right up close damage number, how about our far away damage number? From 6 meters away, which I mentioned earlier is the furthest away an enemy will take damage from base Shatterdive and a Glacier Nade, again, we get two damage numbers. 46 is the base damage from the regular old Shatterdive Glacier Nade combo, and the second number in this case is 11. That's our Whisper of Fissures extra damage number. Again, we whip out the old 3.0.2 patch notes, and 11 is definitely within the range of being somewhere between 30 at max and 4 at worst. Hey, but Fallout, it says the lowest fissures can go is 4. Why is the second number 11 damage at 6 meters away? Good question. Whisper of Fissures on its own can do damage past the point where a Guardian can get hurt by a regular Shatterdive and Glacier Nade combo. Remember I said that cap was 6 meters? Whisper of Fissures on its own goes beyond that. When my buddy goes up to 9 meters away from me and I crash down to break the Glacier Nade, 4 damage. That damage is only the Whisper of Fissures damage, which has the power to hurt Guardians past the 6 meter range on its own. And the 4 damage lines up with the numbers in the 3.0.2 patch notes. Here's a picture that might help you to understand the basics of Shatterdive a little bit more clearly. Again, thank you to Kujay for the very clear info that led to today's update. You can consistently one-hit kill enemies up to 5 meters away with base Shatterdive Glacier Nade. you can consistently one-hit kill enemies to the tail end of 6 meters away with Whisper of Fissures turned on, and once you hit 7 meters, you've officially entered the no-kill zone. From 7 to 9 meters away, your exploding glacier nade will only hurt the enemy with minimal damage, and that's only if you have Whisper of Fissures turned on. So here's the good news. We can say with full confidence that, oh yeah, the Whisper of Fissures nerf went through the 3.0.2 patch. It is turned on for sure. But here's the bad news. Everything I showed in my original video still holds to be true. And by that, I mean that Whisper of Fissures and just plain Shatter Dive on its own is way too strong, in my opinion. Shatter Dive Glacier Nade still has the ability to flat out one-hit kill multiple roaming supers even from 3 to 4 meters away. While I'm glad the potency of the combo was taken back a little bit, I kinda don't think it's enough. I feel that the base damage of Glacier Nade's exploding is still a tad high. I think it's really strange that you can obliterate even beefy supers like Sentinel or Striker Titan with just this one move. And now, with that out of the way, let's quickly touch on something you'll find really interesting. Remember from my video last weekend how goddamned confused we were from the Behemoth Titan? How they took so little damage from Shatter Dive and a Glacier Nade, that's what convinced me that there was something wrong with the patch. That somehow only the Behemoth was playing by the rules of the patch while the other classes weren't. Well, here's an update on that. I think, keyword think, Behemoth might be bugged in that they, for whatever reason, are taking much less damage from Shatter Dive than they should be. Here's the deal, each roaming super has their own level of damage resist. Some are beefier than others, but no matter how beefy a roaming super is, it's always that same level of beefiness across the board. What do I mean by that? Let me show you. Take the Sentinel Titan. Shooting the Guardian normally with a Darcy sniper rifle, they take 119 damage in the body. In their roaming super, they take 56 damage. That means the Sentinel roaming super has about 53% incoming damage reduction, give or take. So that 53% reduced incoming damage should be the same across the board for no matter what you hit the Sentinel Titan with. Here, I have my Sentinel buddy walk up to a Glacier Nade, which I shoot and break in his face. Two damage numbers, as expected, 40 and 14. Remember, one damage number for base Glacier Nade, one for Whisper of Fissures. At max damage, normally, those glacier numbers should be 84 and 30. In Sentinel Titan, they're taken down to 40 and 14. In both cases, that translates to about a 53% reduction in incoming damage. Good, the number matches. Let's try a Shadebinder Warlock. In their roaming super, they take 59 damage from the Darcy. That translates to about a 50% reduction to incoming damage. Now I put my friend near a Glacier Nade, then shoot it right in their grill. The damage numbers are 42 and 15, comparing with the damage you'd take if you weren't in your super, which again would be 84 and 30, you get an incoming damage reduction of 50%. The number matches, no problem there. Now let's look at our old friend the Behemoth Titan. We shoot him with a Darcy, 48 damage. Okay, that's tanky AF, puts the Behemoth Titan in at 60% reduced incoming damage. No big surprise yet, we've covered in the past how the Behemoth is the tankiest roaming super in the game at 60% reduced incoming damage. And now we shoot a crystal in their grill and get the following damage numbers, 7 and 3. That translates to a 90 to 91% reduction in incoming damage from the Glacier Nade. What the TLDR, Behemoth Titans, for some reason, are the only class in the game who take much, much less damage from Shatter Dive and Glacier Nades than anybody else. I have no idea why, and it's what originally threw me off in last weekend's video. I don't know if that is intended, I don't know if it's not intended. If it is intended, I would really like to know why. But yeah, as if they weren't strong enough already. Anywho, just something I thought I would share with you. If you found today's video helpful, dive headlong into the like button, and don't forget to click subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.